Me too. I'm excited to be here too. Always good to be with the High Point family. I gotta tell you, last night we had a great time of worship on Saturday night at Hill City. And I just want to let you know that the Lord's speaking and the Lord's moving and He's doing good things. He's setting people free. He's breaking chains, and I just love it when God shows off. I love it when God shows off. Well, there's no good segue into this, so I'm just going to ask you to stand up and greet each other.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and oh my soul, worship His holy name, and sing like your holy name.
Hey, what's my guitar in the Avion? All right. Turn it down. Right. It's way too loud.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and ask Alyssa and Aubrey to come on up
that's
here.
That's not it.
If you guys could go ahead and find your way back to your seats, that'd be
nine.
Awesome. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus,
nine.
We just thank You for this time together. God, we thank You for the gift of worship. Lord, thank You for the youth at this church and for the life that they bring to us. God, I pray that You would bless the rest of our service. Come, Holy Spirit, we ask in Jesus' name.
Yes,
amen.
God. In the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all the people will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Today we relight the candle of hope and expectation. Let this candle remind us of the great hope we have in the Christ Messiah and in God's promises. As we light the candle of preparation and peace, let us remind us to prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ. Father, guide us in confessions of our sins. We know in the greatness of Your love You have promised to forgive us. Cleanse us as we prepare our lives for the coming of Jesus again. This we ask in His name. Amen.
Amen.
Just stand and worship with us this morning. He became sin. And He became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become His righteousness. He humbled Himself, He carried the cross. Love so amazing. Love so amazing, yeah. Jesus Messiah, name above all, name above all names. Blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners. For sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, the Lord of all.
His body, the bread.
His body, the bread. His blood, the wine.
been poured out, all for love. The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. All our hope and all our hope is in you, and all our hope is in you, and all the glory to you, God, and the light of the world. All our hope. All our hope is in you, and all our hope is in you, God. All the glory to you, God. The light of the world, Jesus Messiah. Above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel. Sing it out, the rescue for sinners.
The rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven.
The Holy One, Jesus, oh Holy One, I sing to you, forgiven, Savior, I'm overcome with your great love for me,
Son of God.
Strength beyond compare.
Son of God, strength beyond compare. You alone, the darkness cannot bear.
Sing how great. Let's just focus on this.
Great is our God. Sing with me how great is our God. And all will see how great. How great is our God.
Just keep playing through that chorus. See your greatness, God. God, we want to meet with you today. I pray that you would just awake this place, God. Awake our hearts today. Let us see how great you are, Jesus. God, and just let us, as an outcry, just worship you, because you are great, God. The splendor of the King.
Bye.
above all names.
You're the name above all names. You are worthy of all praise. And my heart will sing how great is our God.
You're the name above all.
Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
This is how Jesus the Messiah was born. His mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph, but before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her fiancé, was a good man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. Remember this? He was praying, wasn't he? Joseph, son of David, the angel said, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus. For he will do what? He will save his people from their sins. Christmas and Easter are forever linked. We don't apologize for singing about the cross at Christmas. How great is our God. All this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through the prophet. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means what?
God with us.
How great is our God. How great is our God. Thank you. Thank you for singing that. Thank you for reminding us that he's a great God. Bless you. Go ahead.
Amazing.
Lord has promised.
The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. And he will my shield and portion be as long.
Let this song just breathe life into our bones, God. You know, we say, raise up dry bones and bring joy. God, that's my prayer today for this place.
Yeah.
Amazing grace, God. Just breathe amazing grace into the dry bones. There's different ways we can say it, God, but just bring your joy in this place, Lord. God, I want unending joy that just we can't contain, Lord. It's just bursting out, and our bodies just become a representation of who you are. Just plant your joy in us today, Lord.
I'm going to drop a word. Is that cool, Mike? All right. Brian posted that about these dry bones this morning, and I was like, I'm feeling that today, you know? Sometimes in life, like, things just get discouraging, you know, Christian or not, right? We all have bad days. And there are times when you can feel really alone, you know? And the enemy just lies to you because your feelings can sometimes lie to you, right? And tell you that you're alone and you're not wanted or you don't fit in. And that's all lies, guys. And Ryan posted that this morning and I was like, where is that in the Bible? Because I forgot. And it was in Ezekiel somewhere. So I went to Ezekiel 37. And I read this, and I was just like, in my room, like, yes, 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 God, that's for me. That's for us this morning. Ezekiel 37:4 says, then he said to me, speak a prophetic message to these bones and say, dry bones, listen to the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says. Look, I'm going to put breath into you and make you live again. I'll put flesh and muscles on you and cover you with skin I will put breath into you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. If you're feeling dry today, look up to God and say, God, I need muscles and I need new sinews and I need new skin. And God, I need you to breathe into me today. I need new breath, God. I need new life, because that's who you are. You're the giver of life, God. And when I feel alone or I feel disconnected or discouraged, I know that's a lie, God. Show me who I am. And if you pray that, there's no way you'll leave here today still feeling dry. There's no way. Because he answers our prayers and he inhabits our praises.
Amen. 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 The word of the Lord. Amen. I'm going to invite you today to feel free. If the Lord has put someone on your heart who's here, I'm going to invite you at prayer time to go and pray with them. Okay, so we might have movement through. That's okay. Let's not get nervous. If someone comes to you and prays, just receive their prayer today. So if the Lord has that on your heart, go for it. Go for it. Lord, we just want to bless your name. Amazing grace. I always want to keep singing, when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. After 10,000 years, there won't be any more less days left. After 100,000 years, after 1,000,000 years, we still have the same amount of days left. Praise God. Jesus, you came to earth. God came to earth to deliver us from our sins, to deliver us from ourselves, to deliver us from the evil one. And we're so grateful. We're so grateful. Sometimes it occurs to me in our prayer times that there may be people here who just need to confess something. We're not going to ask you to come forward. We're not going to ask you to raise your hands. But just in your heart, maybe you just need to confess something from this week. Maybe it was an action. Maybe it was a word. Maybe it was an unspoken word. Maybe it was something you should have said and you know you just missed it, missed the opportunity. Maybe it was an attitude that you've harbored this week. Whatever. Let's get everything clear between us and him today. It's not just the manger, Lord. It's not just the shepherds and the wise men and the angels. The story of Christmas goes to the cross. And praise God, not just the cross, the empty tomb. Praise God. Praise God. And your word tells us that today you're sitting at the right hand of the Father and you're interceding for us. You're praying for me. I can't grab that, Jesus, that you would care enough to pray for me. Thank you. And yet the word tells us that the Holy Spirit's also praying. For me. And friends, for you. Thank you, God. Thank you that you care enough about us. Thank you that you love us enough. Oh, Lord, we pray right now, God. We pray over this congregation. We pray healing. We pray, Lord, that you would touch people who need a physical touch. But yet, God, we also recognize that there is a perspective here, that someday we're going to all die. Last week we read the story of Lazarus being raised from the dead, and we proclaim when Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth, that he had to say Lazarus' name or all the dead would have come out. You're so powerful, God. But even Lazarus died again. So, Lord, we recognize that you want to give us good things. And we recognize, Lord, that you want to bring healing and restoration and blessing into our lives. But even that is in perspective. It's minor. It's minuscule compared to what you want to do in eternity. So, Lord, help us to focus on the eternal and not the temporal. Lord, as you're bringing healing in bodies and minds and relationships, We also pray, God, that you would bring the ultimate healing of eternal life and peace and joy with the Father and intimacy with the Father. Help us to be the people of God you desire us to be. Lord, we pray that you would bring revival to our city. We pray today, God, in this Christmas season, God, as people are hustling and bustling on the streets of our city, as people are in and out of the restaurants and at the coffee shops and the places of business, I pray that the Spirit of God would move in our city and pray that you would bring people. Lord, Janice and I are praying in our own family that, God, you would bring revelation, that you would bring an awareness of who you are into the members of our family who need Christ. Lord, you can do that in ways that only you know how to do. So, Lord, we're asking today in the name of Jesus that you would just reveal yourself to people. Lord, we're hearing stories all over the world where you're revealing yourself in dreams and visions, and people are coming to Christ. And that seems just miraculous to us. And it is, because it's God. Because God is supernatural. Because God is all-powerful. And so, Lord, we just pray that you would do what you desire to do. Bring the body of Jesus Christ together in our city. Bring churches together. Lord, bring pastors together. Bring congregations together. Bring brothers and sisters in Christ together. Lord, help us at work. Help us at school. Lord, to link arms with brothers and sisters in Christ. Help us, Lord, to form family. Pray today, Lord, for my friend Jason, who pastors at Terra Nova. I pray for Jason, for his wife, and Lord, I know his daughter Maddie is having some issues. I pray for Maddie today. Friends, you don't know Maddie, but Madison, would you pray for Madison today? Would you just lift her? I pray for this congregation, Lord. I pray that you'd encourage Jason. I pray that you'd help him. Lord, I bless you for the role that he plays in our city. And I pray that you would expand that you would build influence in him. God, help. I pray for our district today, our Nazarene district of North Central Ohio, the 65 or so churches that are meeting today, just like we are. We pray for pastors. We pray for churches. God, we need revival in our land. It's not going to come because of a new president or a new governor or a new educational system or a new program or a new bill that's before the elective body. God, we pray today for the moving of the Holy Spirit in our world. We love you, Jesus. We love you. We love you. I know I'd say this all the time, friends, but why don't you pray for the person on either side of you? Just lift them. Kids, you can pray for another person sitting next to you, whether it's a child or a mom or a dad or someone else. Let's all pray for the person beside them. Let's just lift one another today. This is such a beautiful scene for me. Lord, I stand up here and I watch people pray for people across and down. And it's just beautiful. Thank you, God. Thank you. Worship band, pray for each other up there. Sound guys, pray for each other. If you're hearing me in the nursery, pray for each other. We need you, Lord. We need you, God. We need you. We need you. All these prayers are prayed in the name of Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. Amen. Amen. This corner stone, this solid.
Bursting Forth? Can we sing Bursting Forth again?
Do it.
Then bursting forth in glorious day, and up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought by the precious blood of Christ.
Come on, just lift up a shout. Lift up a shout of praise. Woo! Hallelujah! Woo! Praise you, God. Thank you, Lord.
You are precious. You are precious to God. He sacrificed his son for you. He paid a great price. A great price. It's so great a price to give your kid. He gave his son for us. Not because you're sinful and terrible, right? But because you have value. Yes. Because you matter. Your life, it matters. There's a place for you in this world. Yes. There's a calling on your life. Yes. And if you don't know that today, he's going to speak it to your heart. You are great in his eyes. He loves you so much.
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I fail, but I'm not a failure. It's a big difference. That's why I felt led today to pray in our prayer time. Just, there may be someone here. I've had to pray that recently. God, I'm sorry. I'm just sorry. Let's never be afraid to tell God I'm sorry. Because you know what happens often when we don't say it? Our hearts begin at that point to get hard. Let's just stay soft. I'm sorry, Lord. I'm sorry. He loves you. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I have a letter to read to you today. Do you all remember Tom? Our prison buddy, our prison brother? You've never met him and yet you know him. Well, we took a Christmas offering for him, you remember? So he sent the gift, and here's what he wrote. Dear brothers and sisters at High Point, sorry I can't be there to say the things I want to tell you. I'm one of the church's shut-ins. I want you to know I love and appreciate each and every one of you very, very much. Thank you for making this a nice holiday season for me and a wonderful Christmas gift by the offering you gave for me. It's such a blessing, the money, but more importantly, that you cared enough about me to do that. Thank you so much. Not only will it go for a lot of good food that I buy from the commissary, this will probably come as a surprise, but prison food isn't very good. One day they put some yellow runny soup stuff on my tray at lunchtime with a couple lumps in it, and I had to ask them what it was. They said cheese, but I beg to differ. Pastor Mike laughed when I told him on Mondays we get a chicken patty, Tuesday it's a turkey patty, Wednesday it's called chicken fried steak, and Friday it's called crispy chicken patty on the menu, but it's all the same. They just call it different names on different days, as crazy as that sounds. The money will also go to help me buy coffee, hygiene items, and stationery supplies, but I want to tell you also where else it will go. Different organizations offer fundraisers in here. It's usually things that we don't normally get, such as McDonald's, Subway, Pizza Hut, Gordon Food Service. The beautiful thing about that is once the money is raised, more than half of it goes to charities of our choice. Several months ago, we sent $1,700 to Children's Hospital in Columbus. Before that, it went to two schools for the deaf in Columbus and Cincinnati. And more recently, we raised $4,000 and sent 100% of the proceeds to St. Jude's Children's Hospital to help the children with cancer. It almost brings tears to my eyes telling you about that last one. I had to blink them away because we see the commercials on television. Me with, this is so beautiful. Me with my once heart of stone. God's done such a work in my heart. I couldn't get through one episode of America's Got Talent this season without tears. It's not funny. I had to act like I was yawning, stretching my arms, using my sleeve to wipe the tears away so nobody would see me. Here you go. In closing, last year, a place in North Carolina, I took a Bible study correspondence course from, suggested getting names and writing them down of people, friends, and family who are unsaved. And on March 16th, 316, in honor of John 3:16, would be the day we would all pray for over these names. Well, I put up a sign and a sign-up sheet on my dorm offering prayer for people's loved ones to get saved. I only put up one sheet of paper because I thought maybe at most 10 or 15 guys would list anyone on it. When I walked by it on the wall about an hour later, the whole sheet was filled, 30 names. I quickly taped up another sheet. By lunch, it was filled up too. By the end of the day, I had to attach 7 more sheets of paper. 179 names. It was so beautiful seeing people write the names of their wives, girlfriends, friends, and children on those lists, committing them under the Lord's care and trusting Him for their salvation. Such a wonderful thing to witness. Well, I had the special privilege of getting to feel that way again recently. Yesterday, I received a letter from a dear person at the church, this church. It said, "Dear Tom, I wish you could have seen all of your brothers and sisters giving for you today. Pastor Mike makes sure you're part of our family. Maybe I shouldn't tell you, but it sure blessed me to know they care." Unquote. Tom writes, "I've got to go. Those tears again, you know. Happy ones, I assure you. Happy Thanksgiving to all of you. I might be in here, but I have much to be thankful for. Besides the Lord, the thing I'm most thankful for is having you for my family. I mean that with all my heart." That's to you. God bless you, Tom Spurlock. Please keep me in prayer. P.S. He always writes a P.S. P.S. Please stand to your feet and let's give God a great hand clapping praise. Bless His name. He is worthy. We got to do that for Tom, don't you think? And for the Lord? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Well, when do you stop clapping for the Lord? Now that we've started, we shouldn't stop, should we? Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you. I wish you could meet Tom. Someday you will. I wish you could meet him. I'm going to go see him this Wednesday. If you want, I'll tell him that you all said hi. You do that? And God bless him. God bless him. Don't have a lot of announcements these days. In just a moment, we're going to receive the offering. We're going to receive our tithes and our offerings. Let me just give you a word about the next few weeks. We'll have the children's Christmas program 2 weeks from today. And that'll be a high energy day. And it'll be a good day for us. Let me remind you that on Christmas Eve, since Christmas Eve falls on Saturday, this year Hill City is going to just carry our Christmas Eve service. I invite you to go. We're going to have a Christmas Eve communion like we always do. I'll be there on Saturday, and we'll be having communion. We invite those of you who may not be able to come on Christmas morning to come on Saturday night. It's going to be a great service. I know it is. Pastor Luke's going to lead that and share. Thanks for what you're doing there. There. Excuse me. And then Sunday morning, no Sunday school, just one service at 10:30. Isn't it strange that we say when Christmas falls on Sunday, it's awkward? Because church kind of gets in the way of opening the gifts. That's a little bit awkward. But we kind of understand what that means. So do whatever you're going to do with your families and come at 10:30. It'll just be one service, no Sunday school. It'll be a great celebration of the birth of Christ. And then that week, no Wednesday activities. New Year's Eve, no Hill City.
No Hill City on New Year's Eve,
right. And then one service New Year's Eve, Sunday morning, just like we're doing on Christmas. 10:30, New Year's Day. And then we'll be into the new year, 2017. Some of us remember Y2K. And now here we are, 17 years later. Boom. I mean, Y2K was, I think, last month. Yeah. All right, kids, you ready to go? Pastor Ben, lead them out. Ushers, come and receive our morning tithes and offerings. Bless the offering, Lord. Bless what we give. You are so good. We give gladly to you, to the advancement of your kingdom. This isn't our money anyway. It's yours. So we just give you what you've asked us to do. In your name we pray. Amen.
Told me, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. A newborn king to see, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Bum bum bum.
smiled at me. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Me and my drum.
Amen.
I have some good news, and I have... The good news is, if you weren't here last week,